Hey guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. So for today's video, we are continuing my 2018 favorites video series, and I'm going to be doing my blushes, bronzers, and highlighters, the best ones of 2018. So if you want to hear what my favorites are, then just continue watching. Okay, so first of all, my hair's a mess. It is 8 a.m. I am traveling today. In a couple of hours, I'm going to the airport. And here I am filming my favorites. Have it packed. Obviously, I have my priorities straight, right? But anyways, let's just get into the first product. Now, this is not available, but they do have a newer version. You guys saw that I did review it. But I've just been stuck on this OG. I've been in love with the Benefit Cheek Parade. It's just a staple for me. Their new one's just as good. I just really like the old one. So inside, you get a hula bronzer, a hula light bronzer, dandelion blush, which is one of my favorite, like, more delicate blushes, and I really like California as well. I don't really care for Rock Couture, but these four are staples for me. They're great everyday blushes and bronzers, and mine is the highlighter. This is a great all-in-one palette. Really love it, and it smells really delicious. The quality is amazing. I really like how I can use hula light and hula to really create dimension in my face. So this is such a good palette. Totally recommend. Another palette that I have here is the NARS Bordeaux Plague palette. Again, this isn't available, but I'm not gonna lie, this was a favorite of mine for this year. So inside, you get two bronzers and then four highlighters. I really do like the bronzers, but the highlighters are what stand out in this palette to me. I think it has the most beautiful, smooth highlighters. They add so much glow. They don't emphasize texture. These are some of the best highlighting formulas I've ever used. This palette's amazing. It's definitely been a favorite. Love it. So I'm sitting here editing in the dark and I cannot believe I forgot to include the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Edit Unlocked palette. What is wrong with me? I did a review on this palette. It's definitely one of the best face palettes of the year, if not the best. And not only is it one of the best, but it's also Hourglass's best. So if you want to try Hourglass, I definitely recommend this palette. Quality, high grade. The color selection is beautiful for an array of different skin tones. It is such a good palette. Can't believe I forgot to mention it. Wow.
So moving on to bronzers, I've really been into the Marc Jacobs Tantastic bronzer all this year with my Tom Ford brush. You can't get any better than that combo. Dude, it's just such an amazing color. It adds warmth to your face without being too much. There really is no oranginess with this color. It's the perfect bronzer color, and you're never gonna run out because it is huge. Love this bronzer. It's one of my favorites. This is just kind of one of my staples here, the Too Faced Sweethearts bronzers. I don't own a lot of bronzers, but the bronzers I do have, I use them every day. They're like all featured in this video, but I really like this one because it's a shimmery bronzer. It's not orange on my face at all, but it really does warm my face and add a little bit of glow as well. So when I want a shimmery bronzer, this is my go-to. It really stole the show this year for me, and actually, if I had a YouTube channel last year, I would have featured this as well, just because it is so good. Okay, so let's move on to blushes. Now, for some reason, I just became so incredibly obsessed with blush this year. I think it makes a world of difference on your face, and for the longest time, I didn't even notice what the point of blush was for. I thought it was dumb, and now I cannot get enough of blush. I probably go around looking crazy with the amount of blush that's on my face, but I love blush. I bought so many different blushes this year, and honestly, like, there's no reason to have a lot of blushes because, to be honest, a lot of them look the same on your face and you only have like two cheeks. So, but I'm so extra, so whatever. But I had three blushes in particular that really stood out to me this year. So the first one is actually by Sigma, and this is the Aura Powder Face Powder in the shade Cor-De-Rosa. Oh my goodness, you guys, this is just my favorite everyday like neutral blush. It goes with whatever you are wearing. It's a beautiful rose blush. It's so big. I love this blush. I really like the formula, and I actually really should pick up some more Sigma blushes because this formula is so good. But this color is just amazing. Nobody talks about this blush, but she's really, really good. I also jumped on the Milani Luminoso bandwagon. It really is a beautiful blush. It's one of my go-tos whenever I do a warm look, and if you like a little bit of shimmer on your cheeks, you are going to love this blush. So big thumbs up for this guy. Love it. Great formula, awesome product. The hype is real, guys. So this last one really is more so talking about the formula, but I did reach for this color a lot. But this is probably my favorite blush formula. The Hourglass Ambient Lighting Blushes, they are bomb. The one I have right here is Luminous Flush, which I love a pink, good pink blush. And this is just the perfect pink blush. The thing with Hourglass blushes is they blend on the cheeks seamlessly. They don't apply too much color, but they don't apply too little. It just applies the most perfect amount of pigment on your cheeks. They do have a slight glow to them, but it's very natural. Hourglass has like my favorite blush formula, I'm not gonna front. They're expensive, but it's totally worth at least owning one. And like I said, my favorite is Luminous Flush. So if you like a pink blush, try for Luminous Flush if you want to pick one out. Highlighters. I have quite a few just because it's the age of highlighters. You can never have too many, even though that is totally not true. You definitely don't need that many highlighters. They kind of look the same on your face, but you know what? That doesn't stop me. So let's talk about my favorite highlighters of this year. So the first one is actually a very, very affordable one, and this is the Wet n Wild Highlighting Bar in the shade Earth. So this came out in their horoscope collection, that one. I hated everything from that collection except for this. Like, I purchased that whole collection and everything I bought I thought was awful. And then this highlighter did steal the show. It's just applies the most beautiful golden glow to your cheek. It's really, really beaming too. I'm surprised this cheap little highlighter created such a beam, but it looks so smooth on the skin. It applies so much pigment and so much shine to your cheek. For just a few bucks, I am beyond impressed with this highlighter. I've been loving it this year. Whenever I want a gold highlighter, this is it. This is kind of a staple of mine. I've been using it for years, but I always go back to it, especially with a pink look. The Bobbi Brown Pink Glow Highlighter. First of all, you'll get more product than you'll ever, ever use. I've used this so many times, and I feel like there's not even really a dent. There's a small dent up here, but for as much as I use it, I should have hit pan long, long ago. This is one of my go-to everyday highlighters. It's really beaming. I heard somebody say they didn't like it, and I'm like, what? You're crazy. This is so good. I don't get how it doesn't work for people, because it really applies such a nice glow. It was very even on your skin, and it's like almost natural but still beaming. So this year I discovered Artist Couture, their little diamond glow powders. So this one is in the shade Illuminati. I'm in love with this. This I love really for like Instagram, because I'll just put it right on top of the highlighter I'm already wearing, and then boom, like you can see me from outer space. This isn't like everyday for me, but you know, for Instagram, it is a bomb, and I want more colors. This is surprisingly a favorite of mine. I started off like liking it, but not really thinking it would be such a hit in my collection. But the Charlotte Tilbury Bar of Gold palette, this has been my favorite as an everyday highlighter. You can really build it up to really get it beaming, but I just like it because it's so smooth on the skin. I'm saying this about every highlighter, but I like highlighters for a certain reason. And this actually I've been keeping more so in my makeup kit than my everyday, like what I wear, just because this works so great on brides. I don't know, if you're getting married and you're looking for a good highlighter, I've been so in love with this palette. Though gold in particular is what I've been using, but I will dip into the center shade as well. But these are such a beautiful, beautiful formula. If you're a Charlotte Tilbury fan and you were wondering about this highlighter, it's one of my favorites. So really lovely palette. At first I regretted purchasing it because I was like, I think I wasted my money, but honestly, no. Moving on, this I got in a little Jouer set last year from Holiday, so this is a mini one, but the powder highlighter in the shade Citrine. This little guy is blinding. Now it's a very soft formula, so you get a lot of powder and pick up on your brush when you apply it, so that's half of the reason why it is so blinding. But this I found myself reaching for, like I never necessarily thought it would be my favorite, but I realized like I used this a ton this year. It just is the perfect color for so many different looks. It's like champagne-y with a subtle gold, and it's just a really great color. I really like that it is a looser formula, so you do get more product on your cheek, which makes it glow even more. That being said, I heard these break very easily, so maybe don't bring these to travel, but you know, when it's sitting in my drawer, I love to use this. So this one is a more new favorite of mine. It's a more recent purchase. This is the Diorskin Nude Air Luminizer in Holo Pink. Now, this is an amazing formula. The glow is beautiful on your cheek. It is a pink, so if you are deeper, I would go with the gold that they have. But the formula of this is just so beautiful. It's so beaming. It's different. Like, this is hard to get your hands on because they don't sell it at just like any Dior counter or any Dior Sephora. Like, I had to search for this. It's a beautiful, you know, it's the beautiful Dior formula. I don't want to talk about it too much, but it's like really good. I'm like describing all of the highlighters the same, but okay, so the last one is the Dior Backstage Glow Face Palette. This guy is like, I'm gonna say right now, the best highlighter of 2018. I did kind of stick to these top two. I would mix them a lot, and then I could really personalize it by getting a little extra glow. This highlighter has a very unique formula, in my opinion. Of all the formulas that made my face smooth, this made my face the smoothest. I think if you're gonna have one highlighter in your collection, you should pick up this palette because you can really personalize it because you get more colors. You have a beautiful blush topper, or on deeper skin tones, you have two beautiful highlighters down here. But this is a great lid color, and this is a great blush topper. I just love this formula. It is so good. If you were thinking about picking up this highlighter palette, like, go for it. It is amazing. It's been my favorite. Okay, so my mouth is dry. I'm hungry. I need to pack, but I still have one more favorites video to film. I'm gonna eat breakfast though. Thank you guys for watching this video. Remember to subscribe to my channel, like this video, check out my other 2018 favorites, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.